In this tutorial, I will show you how to buy and install WordPress on your Namecheap Hosting account, step by step. I will show you which hosting plan you should choose and the actual buying process involved. I will then show you how to install WordPress on Namecheap the right way and choosing the correct settings. Towards the end of this video, I will give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up Namecheap through my link below. I will give you my six-figure blogger course for free. And without anything else to do, let's get started. Step one is to click the link in the description or type in .com/go/nc into your browser. It will take you to my special Namecheap discount page where you will get the best discount Namecheap is currently offering. Full transparency, this is an affiliate link. I will receive a small commission while you get a special discount and my six-figure blogger course for free. So it can be a win-win situation for the both of us, and I really appreciate you supporting my channel. So first of all, if we scroll down to the plans, you can see there are three main options available: the Stellar, Stellar Plus, and Stellar Business. So we won't talk about the Stellar Business for now, as it is more of a cloud hosting solution. I just want to discuss the Stellar and Stellar Plus, as they are the standard shared hosting plans that most of you will want to purchase. The main difference is the Stellar plan allows you to have 20 gigabytes of storage and 3 websites, whereas the Stellar Plus plan has unlimited for both and the added extra of the auto backup, which I believe is really important. So it's pretty easy to decide here. If you're just starting out and you only need one or two websites, then go with the Stellar. If you need more than that and you want that extra benefit of the auto backup, then go with the Stellar Plus. A quick note here is they have two locations for their data center. If you want to host your website in the UK, then you can click on this option and it will add an extra dollar per month. But if your customers and your business is closer to the UK as opposed to the US, then it is worth the extra money, as it'll allow your website to load faster for your customers and they will have a better experience with you. But for me, it's the US. And the next thing is Namecheap has three types of payment plans: the monthly, the yearly, and the 2 years. So as expected, if you choose the 2 year, it's going to be cheaper per month. This is the one that I always recommend you buy if you're happy with the service, as there's always a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not happy about it within the first month, then you can cancel and get all your money back. So go with the 2 year option if you can, but for this tutorial, I only need the yearly. And one last thing I want to mention is, if you scroll back up to the top from my custom link that I provided you, there will be an up-to-date promo code that you can use to get an extra discount from the current pricing. So just make sure to click on this button here to copy it to clipboard, and then scroll down, pick your plan, and click on Get Started. I'm going to choose the Stellar Plus here. Now in the domain section, you can either choose a new domain or an existing domain name. I myself have all my domain names with Namecheap and would highly recommend it, as they are one of the cheapest out there and are very reputable. So if you need to choose a new domain name, come down to here, search for your domain name, and click on Add to Cart. But for me, I already have a domain name with Namecheap, so I'm going to click on Existing Domain Name, and then I will sign in. And you will have to either create a new account or sign in with your existing account. And now it will bring me back to the previous page where I can choose the domain name that I want. So I'm going to choose this one, click on Connect to Hosting, and now you can add it to cart. This is now the final step before confirming your order. You can see everything looks right, but here is where you can put in your promo code that I told you to copy in the previous step. And now click on Apply and you will see the price decrease from $31.84, and it's now down to just $19.88 for 1 year of hosting. That to me is an amazing deal. So I'm happy with everything and I'll click on Confirm Order. Fill out your payment method and details, click Continue again. Review your order and click on Pay Now. And that's it, our purchase has been successful. So the next step is to go and install our WordPress website onto our chosen domain name. So we click on Manage, and we can come down to the software section and click on WordPress, and now click on Install Now. Make sure the URL is correct. Fill out the name and description. And come down to the admin account. Pick a username and password. And for me, I recommend using anything that's not admin. It makes it harder for hackers to try and get into your account. Now we come down to the plugins. Just untick this one as we won't be using it. And now under the advanced options, we will come down to the automated backups and click on once per day. And go down again to the very bottom and click on install. And we'll wait for this to load. And that's it, our WordPress website has been fully installed. We still have another step to go, but I just wanted to quickly ask you if you're getting value from this video. If so, just let me know by liking my video, and you can subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on more quality content just like this, which I release every single week. Now the next step is to install our SSL certificate. And we come back to Namecheap, click on SSL/TLS, click on Manage SSL Sites. Now come down and select your domain. Click on Autofill by Domain. And then click on Install Certificate. Click OK. And we can see now that our SSL certificate has been fully installed. Now the next step is to create our email account. So we once again go back to Namecheap. And under the cPanel shortcut, we click on email accounts, and it will take us back to our cPanel. Once again, it's very simple here. Just click on create, put the username you want, use admin, your password. Now scroll down and click on create. And that's it, it's that simple. And now the last step is to make sure to double check that our WordPress and SSL certificate has been installed correctly. So to do that, we go to Namecheap, go to the top, click on Go to cPanel, and from the cPanel page, we click on Softaculous, and go to the installations, and here's the website that we've just installed. So to check the website that it's working properly, click on it. We can see here the page is loaded fine. And to check if the SSL certificate is working, you just go to this lock icon and it says connection is secured. That means it worked properly. And now if you want to log in to your WordPress backend, you go back to Softaculous and just click on this human icon here. And that's it. You are now in your backend and you can start tweaking your website. Just a quick note on my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up Namecheap through my link, then just quickly send me your receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I'll send you access to my bonus course immediately. Now that you have successfully installed WordPress onto your bare bones Namecheap hosting account, you're actually ready to build out your full website. And to help you with this, you can watch this next video here, and I'll see you in that next tutorial.